instead of trying to find a definition, we decided to show you facets of Latin culture through the eyes of some Peck families here with us who have roots in Latin America and Latin culture. These slides were painted especially for our assembly by Mrs. Constance Silverman, mom of Charlotte Silverman. And I want to give a very, very special thank you to Mrs. Silverman and Charlotte for helping us with this assembly. One of the most festive, colorful celebrations of Latin culture, Carnival. Take it away, Mr. Ryder. Narrator of our play, mother of Tom and Ben Pulaski, Mrs. Cecilia Pulaski.
Buenos días, amigos. Bienvenido. Bonjour. Those are the languages spoken throughout Latin America, Spanish, Portuguese, and French. These languages are all derived from Latin, and that's where we get the name Latin America. Where's Latin America? It's a trick question. Latin America isn't really a place, it's a culture. There are more than 20 countries spread throughout Central America, South America, and the Caribbean that are part of Latin America. Let's listen now to Corbin Menard and J.D. Figueroa tell us about the nation of Trinidad. J.D. will play Nicki Minaj, who is from Trinidad.
I was born in Trinidad, and the richness of my culture has had an immense influence on my success. I love the explosive colors of Carnival and the steel band, which was invented in the 1940s.
My mom was also born in Trinidad. She has told me so much about the history of Carnival.
Well, this festival started with the French laborers and African slaves who had come, and they decided to have a Spanish festival. Then Carnival arrived when the African slaves and French laborers could not join the festival, so they formed their own celebration called Carnaval, which over the years has evolved into the colorful celebration we know today as Carnival.
So Carnival is like Trinidad, a niche, a festival and celebration for the multicultural nation that is Trinidad.
You heard JD say that the Spanish ruled Trinidad. The Spanish made settlements throughout the Caribbean and the Americas starting in the 15th century. To find out more about it, we will now travel back 500 years to a time when Spain was ruled by King Ferdinand and Queen Isabella, played by Danny Colon and Ariel Klassen.
Spain is a great country thanks to our skill in navigating ocean trade routes to Asia.
But those trips take so many months and are so expensive. There must be a faster way.
Yes, we will send out explorers to the west to find new trade routes.
Yes, and Spain will remain a great empire.
Ferdinand Ferdinand and Isabella sponsored many explorers, such as Christopher Columbus, Hernan Cortes, and Juan Ponce de Leon, who sailed across the Atlantic Ocean with ships full of Spanish settlers. They spread their language, Spanish, and their religion, Catholicism, everywhere they went. That is why today, more than 400 million people speak Spanish throughout Latin America. One of the places those Spanish settlers came to live was an island we now call the Dominican Republic. Questi Adjudiawa plays Yankees player Robinson Cano, and J.D. Figueroa is a Dominican student in our next scene.
Back here in the Dominican Republic to visit my family and friends.
I see you still like merengues, the national dance of the Dominican Republic.
That's right, and baseball is our favorite sport.
What? I thought baseball was only played in the U.S.
Not at all. Dominicans are crazy about baseball.
And merengue.
To Cuba. Cuba is one of the world's last remaining communist countries, and it feels as if it's locked back in the 1950s. Only a tiny fraction of the population has ever been in line, and most cars driven are from the 1950s. Although Cubans have been deprived of so much, they carry on with their culture and traditions. They share a passion for dancing and celebrating with family and friends. Cuban singer Gloria Estefan, played by Jordan McGinley, sings about her longing for Cuba in our next scene, along with Lauren Clough.
Became the leader of Cuba, everything changed for the worse. There was a mass exodus for freedom, and many Cubans left with little of their thanks to start a new life where they would have freedom. Today, the hope for freedom lives strongly in the hearts of all Cubans.
Like that fortress, El Moro, which means the rock, Cuba is strong.
Yes. Her music, her family, her culture live on through us forever. When I hear the rhythms of her music or taste the sweetness of a plátano, I think of Cuba.
How about we go get some right now?
Puerto Rico, an island with an interesting government structure. We'll hear from Luis Fortuño, the current governor of Puerto Rico, played by Ben Bollinger. He then has learned all about it from his mother, who is Puerto Rican.
Puerto Rico is an official territory of the United States, and our people are U.S. citizens, but we do not vote in the national presidential elections. We are not a state, but we have our own governor, me, and our own Supreme Court. Both English and Spanish are our official languages, but most Puerto Ricans speak primarily Spanish. As governor, I hold a high selected position, and I represent an island full of warm, fun-loving people who enjoy many types of music and dancing. We welcome millions of visitors every year, like the boy from New Jersey in this photo, Ben Bollinger. He is standing in front of the 400-year-old Spanish fort called El Moro in the capital of Puerto Rico, San Juan. Also pictured here are his grandparents, who, among many other Puerto Ricans, emigrated to the United States. Did you know that there are now as many people of Puerto Rican descent living in the mainland U.S. as there are living in Puerto Rico? Many Puerto Rican immigrants have gone on to great success. You may know American Idol judge Jennifer Lopez, New York Giants wide receiver Victor Cruz, and U.S. Supreme Court Justice Sonia Sotomayor. Hey, is that a pet cap is that Willow is wearing?
Yeah. Our tour of Latin America ends with a visit to Mexico, the land of mariachi music, famous artists, and strong Catholic traditions, portrayed by Tom and Ben Pulaski and Krista Benyon.
Soy como el viento que corre.
Could you tone it down? I'm trying to prepare my altar for the Day of the Dead.
Now I'm working on my latest mural. After all, I'm one of the most famous muralists who ever lived. I'm Diego Rivera.
My mariachi music is an important part of our Mexican culture too. Mariachi is used at Day of the Dead ceremonies.
It is a happy time to celebrate and remember loved ones who have died. The Mexican people create altars in honor of the dead whose spirits they believe travel to earth to celebrate with them. On my altar, there's lots of stuff to celebrate the life of Frida Kahlo, who was a Mexican painter. I have paintbrushes and colored pencils to represent her as an artist. I have a candle, which represents faith and hope and helps guide the spirits on their journeys. I also have a cup of water because water is considered the source of life and it quenches the thirst of the spirit. I also have bread and fruit, which is a feast for the dead to enjoy. Lastly, I have flowers, which are the impermanence of life, and a picture of Frida Kahlo and a picture of one of her paintings. The Day of the Dead is celebrated November 1st and 2nd, and is one of a very significant holiday in Mexico.
Very cool, Krista. Now can I get back to playing?
Que bueno baila usted, which means how well you dance.